right now, Inagua was another island they got hit. I know that's a lot more rural and not as inhabited, but certainly, you know, places like Crooked Island this morning, maybe eventually Andros, if the storm stays on a northerly track, Andros will be hit this afternoon. And then it's all about the Keys. All right? It's all about the Keys. Here it comes. So should this storm, at least the center part of it, the machine, the heartbeat of it, stay over the central part of the state, there will be a gradual winding down of the wind field. But because the pressure's so low and the wind field is so wide, and the waves have already been produced, they're already making their way toward the southeast coast. And in places like Charleston, it's an interesting dance between tide, rainfall, the intensity of that rain, and what's going on with the storm surge component at the time. And Jen Carfagno is in Charleston to talk about that. Good morning, Jen.
Yeah, Jim, good morning. I think there's no way we can avoid flooding here in Charleston. The right tide levels are going to be up. Just how high up, that is the question now, and that craft will make a difference with that. We talked a lot about logistics, right, about vehicle travel on the road, about air travel. Let's talk about ship travel. Let's talk about an important part of the economy here in South Carolina, and talk about the South Carolina Ports Authority. Jim Newsom, CEO, thank you so much for being here. Let's just talk about how you guys are preparing for Irma.
Well, it takes us 48 to 72 hours. Ships can finally have to leave. So the way this storm is planning to hit, we can run normal gate hours through Saturday afternoon. We plan to work ships through Saturday night. And then, of course, the ships have to evacuate the harbor while the storm is coming. And then we will button down the port by Sunday, and we anticipate an arrival for, say, Monday night at midnight. So there's a lot of preparation. Our team knows how to do it very well. Interestingly, the most difficult thing is empty containers because they're light and they're stacked high, so they have to be secured as best possible.
I just saw a ship with, you know, a BMW just getting out of here. So obviously, right. You know, companies want their freight to get out of here before the storm gets here.
Right. So BMW is a special case. Obviously, they're expensive vehicles, and we were fortunate to be able to coordinate. We have about 7,000 to 10,000 vehicles on our terminal at any one point in time, but with proper coordination, we've been able to get all.
This is expected to hit as a strong